How to start this video. I have to give you guys a shout out, give Keys a shout out. What is going on, guys? In today's video, we're gonna be installing Olin Rotatrack coilovers in my E46 M3. But obviously, before I start this video off, I wanna give a huge shout out to Keys Motorsports for sending me these coilovers for the E46 M3, and huge shout out to North Rally Performance, who's gonna be doing the install for the car, for the coilovers today. This is not gonna be a super informative video, like showing you guys how to do it and like what tools you need and such, but I'm just gonna do like a really nice cinematic video for you guys, so you can just sit back and enjoy that. But yeah, bing bong. So before we start, we're just gonna have Eric measure from, I think, what, the center cap, is that what you're gonna do?
No, usually bottom of the wheels.
Bottom of the wheel. So we have a suspicion that either this car is a lift kit or this is not the stock suspension or something, because this car is sitting way too high. Like, most stock E46 M3s do not sit this high, as you guys can see. What are we at?
61.75.
Oh god. So the front's actually really bad. The back is still like, nah, I'm not even gonna say it. The back's bad too. It's honestly mostly the front that's really bad, but the whole car is just honestly shit.
All right, so we got the measurements down. Now we're just gonna go ahead and put the car up on the lift and then start the install. So yeah, enjoy this one, guys. So as you guys just saw the car pulling away, we had a couple things that happened off camera that I do want to talk about really fast. As you can see, the car is literally freaking dumped. It's super low, but it's also not at the same time. It's just sometimes when the lighting hits the top of the tire, the shadow makes it seem like it's a lot lower than it really is, but it's not. So we actually measured everything. I'll put the measurements in the description if you guys are interested in that and knowing, but I think the car looks amazing now. It looks much better lowered, and I think it's time for some wheels ASAP. Damn, that shit is fucking loud. Holy shit.
Jesus. Probably broke my mic with that one.
I didn't realize how fucking loud your car is, Max. Damn.
Yeah, it's pretty fucking loud.
No, that's fucking too fucking loud. But anyway, overall, so what ended up happening is the front was rubbing a little bit, so we got some spacers, 15 millimeter spacers running on the front now. So basically, we can freaking not rub while we're driving, and then we also rocked some studs. Shout out to Evan for letting me use his. Yeah, so that's just temporary for now until I get actual wheels, but I think it came out awesome. You guys can check out the before and after pics right here. For some reason, I don't know why, the before, if you can see right now on the screen, the front was literally like monster trucking crazy, and now in the after, as you can see, it's like a lot more fucking dip. Like, it looks a lot lower. So obviously super happy with the outcome. Eric, thank you so much for the install, dude. I appreciate you. I want to give a huge shout out to Keys Motorsports for sending me these coilovers. If you are interested in buying these, go ahead and check the description. I will leave a link down below for you guys who are interested. These are the Road and Track, so this is how low they go. If you are thinking about dumping your car like lower than this, you obviously cannot, because this is the lowest they go, front and back. And I also want to give a huge shout out to North Rally Performance for hooking it up with the install. They did a great job. Aside from the rubbing and stuff, the car's not making any sounds at all, so they obviously did a great job on that. And I hope you let me know if you guys want more videos like that around at the shop. I will be sure to do that for you guys. But anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. Take care. Peace out.